Hi Cancer, welcome to your November 2019 reading. Welcome. Okay, so let's jump right in to what I'm seeing for the month of November. Alright, so Cancer, if this reading resonates for you, then I'm feeling that in the month of November, you will be kind of in a, I don't know what to say. You'll be in, it's almost like a little bit of a personal victory kind of mode, because I'm seeing here wisdom of the divine feminine. So I think that you will be in a place where you will have come through something that was big. I think that you, during this situation, you may have taken, oopsies, actions to remedy. And like, you know, sometimes, because I gotta be honest, I feel like there was some situation that maybe you got caught with your hand in a cookie jar kind of a situation. And if it's not you and it's somebody else in you're in connection with. But it's almost like, almost get the feeling that, yes, you may have been party to that. Like, I'm getting you may have been a third party situation. You may have been the third party or something to that effect where your hands were caught in a cookie jar along with someone else. And I'm actually seeing the hand right here. Now, but I feel that once this happened, and there's her hand right here as well. So I'm feeling that once this happened, I think that you took it upon yourself to start taking right action. And so whatever this was and whenever it was, whether it was last month or months before, whatever this is, you have come out on top. Because I see that you've been working to kind of clear yourself of this energy, to get yourself through this period of your life and whatever it is that happened. And I'm seeing the victory card here. Now, these top three cards I want to pull out because they are not part, they're like, they're their own mini segment of the story. So usually Spirit has me start with the cards up there, but I'm being drawn to starting here. So I feel that the energy that came through is like, you've got this warrior pose. It's like batting your chest, like I, and it's like a self-decree, like a decree to yourself. Like, and I'm feeling like I want to cry now because I have this energy of conviction. That's what it is, conviction. I will never be caught in a situation like that again. That's what I'm getting. I feel that you were caught up in some kind of situation. It was designed to teach you, because I'm seeing school around this. Either this was related to school, you were at a school, someone else was at school. But at the very least, this was like a, oh, okay. The word I'm wanting to say is legendary letdown. And this is kind of triggering for me too, because I can relate to this story, except, you know, the third party would be, this would be their reading. So I'm definitely struggling through this reading. All right, guys. But I'm feeling that this is like legendary letdown is what I'm getting from this energy here, because I'm feeling that it's like one, two, three people related here, and a really, I'm getting the word severe misfire. So it's almost like this looks like a gun, but also a penis, sorry, just to keep it real, but that's the image that's coming. But it's like a severe misfire. And Cancer, if this is your energy, again, you can be anyone here, but I'm feeling this feels like a real, like, I learned my lesson, I don't ever want to be part of this, this is not who I am. This is like, it's a moral situation here that you were dealing with. And it's almost like, I'm just getting this idea of your role as coming in between two solid foundations, almost like, see, coming in between, and it's kind of like creating this rift, all right? And we see that energy here as well, where you're in the middle here and creating this rift. So this really does feel like it could be a third party situation if this reading resonates for you. Again, as the Cancer, you could be anyone in this role. You could be the third party, which is what I'm feeling, or you could be the person who was cheated on, or you could be the adulterer, so to speak. That's the word Spirit wants me to use in these cases. So I would say that as you're reading, if this reading even resonates for you this month, because we can't be for every month, God bless, right? Then which role are you? Okay, I'll leave that up to you to decide. But for whatever this is worth, I feel this brought a lot of, I would say ruin in a big way. And
it's like you may have found yourself caught in the middle of this epic breakdown. That's the best word I could say. But I'm seeing that here in the month of November, I keep wanting to say December, so December may be, in the end we'll pull some cards, just a few cards to see if I remember, dear God, to see what's coming up in December for you. But I'm seeing that in the month of November, Spirit is saying, you've come a long way. You've come a long way. And I'm actually seeing you looking elsewhere now. So if you were caught up in a third party situation and you were the third party and you thought you liked somebody or just whatever that was, I'm seeing that you're already looking elsewhere. You're on to looking at other stuff. But I feel that Spirit was working with you, but I also feel that you took efforts, you took actions where it's like, oh my God, I'm in the wrong here. It may have dawned on you at some point. I'm in the wrong here. And you started to kind of work on yourself and do the best you could to, under the circumstances, to move that energy is what I'm getting. Move that energy. Move that energy out of your field. I'm seeing that here as well. And I think that you may have been successful. Again, I'm getting a real school feeling from this here. It feels like a school. So either you were at school or at a school, or this was an education for you. But either way, that's what I'm getting. Now, where does Spirit want me to go next? Yeah, so let's go right here. Okay. So, in these four cards, I'm feeling, yeah, this may have had something to do with, yeah, again, I'm getting this word, epic letdown, a major letdown. And we see this with the Page of Cups. Remember, the Page of Cups in the regular tarot, it usually looks different from this. This is the after tarot, and that's, it's supposedly taken a moment after the tarot cards happen, the traditional tarot scenes happen. So in this case, whenever I see this Page of Cups, it looks like a misfire in love, but the words epic letdown, it just keeps coming back. And I'm seeing this here, and I'm hearing it's one for the history books, it's one for the storybooks. And it's like you're watching this thing like fall out and you're like, what happened? I'm seeing this King of Swords coming in, and it's almost like before you knew it, it's like you were off your horse, you were, right, this whole, it's almost like this force came in and just changed things. And it was such a big force. Look, it just threw the fish out. And I see that what happened from that moment was this melee, so to speak, this major capsizing, this major thing, and it was just conflict. And that's the best I can say. If this reading is for you, regardless of whatever role you play, then you know what role you were, okay? Or this sounds very familiar for you. But here's the energy that I'm seeing. Oopsies. Here's the energy that I'm seeing for you now. Queen of Wands, all right? I'm seeing you as Queen of Wands. That's a great cleanup act there. Yeah, and I'm seeing it's almost, there's that school again, I'm getting. It almost looks a little Harry Pottery. Harry Pottery with that little V-neck there. And so I'm seeing it's almost like with honors. So whatever this is, I feel that you did a good job in cleaning up your own energy, owning up to what you've done, in a sense, like between you and God. At the end of the day, all of these things are always going to be between us and God, and that alone. And of course, God will arrange it when I don't want to say punishments, but karmic balancing happens, you know, karmic debts and all that, God meets that all out, M-E-T-E-S, meets all of that out. But there's always going to be that initial connection with God and us. And that's kind of the only person we need to answer to unless told otherwise. Now, oh, there's so many places to go on here. I don't even know where, like the story. Okay. All right, let's come here. What I'm seeing here are these three cards, illusion, spontaneity, and mystical, but they have their counterparts down here. So the first card that I'm going to show you is the illusion card. So I feel that you may have been working under some real illusions before, but the thing about the way illusions work is, the things that are illusions sometimes look so real to us. We all go through it. It's so real that we're seeing this, right? But maybe that's the illusion itself. See this little tree or this plant or whatnot that's being reflected in the water? But then when we look up here, it's like, whoa, That is a whole damn tree. How did I get from here to here? You know? So this is telling me that it's quite possible that what you thought you were seeing as something maybe that wasn't so strong, that wasn't so, like, whether it's something like you thought that whatever this, that relationship wasn't strong enough, and maybe that person said that you guys weren't a big deal, that him and her weren't a big deal, or just whatnot. I feel maybe you thought you were seeing something legitimate, and we even see like these watermarks, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like it's almost like this is a lens through a lens through a lens, and it just was so not seen well. To the point that when you caught yourself and you looked up, it's like, oh my God, it's not some flimsy plant that I was seeing. This guy said him and his wife weren't much. He said or she said that they weren't serious. And then I look up and holy shit, this is a whole damn tree. And we got little sproutlings, little kids around it. Like, what? And that's when you start to realize that sometimes not everything that you see is real. And I think that this is a transition that you've had to go through. And I feel that right now, this is where you are today. So again, Spirit is coming through to let you know that you've made a lot of leaps and bounds. You've made a lot of progress. And this is the kind of progress, I think, that we can only see in one who is truly focused on the spiritual journey. Because I think a lot of times, and God bless you and God bless everybody in this, but I think a lot of times people think that they have to take years and years to work through something. But then you meet somebody who's like, okay, no, I made the spiritual decree, I'm gonna work on God, on myself, God, I might give it up to you, what is it that you want me to do, and I actually follow what you want me to do, and I work through the energy and emotions, and then, you know, they work through it in like a few months, I'm getting 11 months, and whereas it takes somebody else like 6 years, you know. And this is not to say anything about anybody and their rate of healing. It's just a matter of, it's just fact. Some people heal faster than others because of the way that they're focusing. Maybe they have just a different personality, so it lends itself to that. But I'm just seeing here, clear viewing, no longer an illusion, but clear viewing. Here, I see what you were in before as well. It's like all this unfocused energy, right? All of this energy around and this feeling of spontaneity and creativity and being free and wanting to connect and experience. And now here we are looking at what seems to be mirroring, but look at this control. This is control of the energy. Realizing that not everything that you see, again, is exactly as it is. And knowing that you have to control your energy no matter what it is that's presented to you. Because we can't just go around being this. In other words, we can't just go around having what we want, or we can't just go around saying what we want. And, you know, we have to still be responsible for our actions in this 3D world. And that's just, yeah, that's just what I'm seeing. I'm seeing full control of energy now. This shows me maturation on a spiritual level, right? And this third card, what I'm seeing is just this mysticism. This is the unbridled. This is the untamed. This is just clear, sheer creativity that is waiting to happen. I feel that as of now, you've dipped your hands into the fabric of creation, and now here you are today. Excuse me. With that control, with that knowledge. Look at that wisdom on the palms of your hands, on your fingers, and ding, 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 ding. Look, ding, 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 ding. So it's like here you are just in a better place in life in general to be a better actor upon the world. So what I'm seeing again, so if this reading resonates with you, Cancer, just to summarize, I feel that you may have been involved in a situation that really, really taught you a huge lesson. I think it's school related. Either you were at a school or you were in school, with fellow students, or this is an education in and of itself. But for whatever it is, I feel that there may have been a situation that you may have made some missteps and made some mistakes. I get this getting your hand caught in a cookie jar kind of feeling. And if it's not you, it may be someone else in a connection with you. And you'll know if this month's reading is for you by now. You'll definitely know. I feel that you've come through it. You've definitely come through it. And I love what I'm seeing here, because we see that once this situation happened, a clear tower moment. I'm not actually getting a tower card here, but trust me, there was one. I could feel it, but you're just so in a different frequency, and there's been time that I feel that it's been transmuted. But I'm seeing it made you look up and it made you look down. I'm seeing being receptive and asking for guidance, and I'm seeing you be humble and asking the earth for forgiveness. It's interesting. It's a wonderful and beautiful way to transmute energy. So I'm definitely seeing as above, below, full transmutation here. And that's why things have gone so well. I mean, we have the victory card clearly. We have, I didn't show it to you. Oh, I did show it to you. Victory card clearly. We have illusions being corrected. We've got energy and focus being controlled. And we have here quality and credibility to act with upon the world. That's spiritual maturity and transmutation of a tower moment. We also have this card. I feel that there may have been some mistakes due to untimely actions is what I'm getting. There was something wrong with the timing in whatever was happening. There's something very wrong with the timing. And when I say that, I feel that there was something that was already underway in its own way. There was a timing that was involved in whatever was happening. I do feel that this was another couple that maybe you may have come between. That's just what it feels like. And I feel that with that timing, whatever happened, it kind of created, as I said, this epic letdown and whatnot. But Spirit is saying to instead where you are, because that's now creating a timing issue for whatever that was, those two people were. But they're saying for the person who was the third party, whether it's you, Cancer, or someone else, they're saying that for you now, though, your way ahead is straight ahead. And I'm seeing here, it's like, I can't even explain it to you. What is that? It's just like a gateway, moving straight. And then straight in for teaching, healing, just moving straight on your path. Okay? So you're continuing on your path. That's what I'm seeing. So if there was a third party that you were connected with, I just feel like now you are back on your path. And you're no longer kind of involved with that, giving to that. I feel like this reading's not going to be long because it's already 17, it's only 17 minutes and we've already gotten through a lot. And that makes sense because look how clear the energy is. It's like, whew, just straight path. All right. So I'm seeing for you, Cancer, that the situation may have taken a lot of courage on your part. Maybe there are times when you felt you could have been a little bit more courageous, a little bit more forthcoming, a little bit more on the up and up, whatever it is that you'd like to say, maybe more honest, maybe just whatnot. But even though I'm seeing that this clearly has the makings of choice here, there are some parts where there may have been destiny as well. And I know that's hard to explain to you guys, but I'm saying not every single thing, based on where I'm standing, God bless, and we all know everybody has different vantage points. Based as a reader, what I've seen and come to believe is that even though two people seem to be living the similar lives, they may not have had similar choice points. For some people, a third party was not a choice. It was a karmic agreement that was activated because it needed to be. Whereas another person, that third party contract was activated out of pure free will, and the shadow work hadn't been done, so that went into that level. In this case, it may be, and they're saying, it's fair to saying it's common for both sides of the coin to be present in any one encounter, right? And so, they're saying that what that is like, sometimes if one person has a choice point, for example, to cheat or not cheat, that activates somebody else's chart. And the agreement, the soul agreement, is that if you want to cheat, then you can activate it on me because I do owe a karmic debt to you. And in this lifetime, I'll give you an opportunity to work through that karmic debt. And if you don't activate it in this lifetime, then we can try again in another lifetime, and I can be the third party that you cheat with. But in this lifetime, if you, you know, you see what I mean? So it's, there's a lot going on anyway, long story short. But I'm seeing that there are elements of destiny in here, but I also do feel that maybe there's some free will. And of course, there are different people on this call as well. So please remember that personal readings cannot and never will replace. I mean, can never be replaced by general readings like this. You just can't, because there are too many energies in a mix. With that being said, yeah, I'm just feeling like the angels were all over this situation. This seems... It just seems like a big... It just seems like a lot of... I can't explain it, but just a lot of sacred energy around. When I say sacred energy, just... It seems like this was a very big deal. Like, maybe some real damage was done and a lot of guides had to get involved, damage control. Like, it just seems like a big thing. And maybe had to be unknotted, or I don't know. But that's what I meant when I said that epic letdown, epic downfall. I just feel like two things were going, and then here comes this thing in the middle. So it's kind of a situation, I think, that turned out to be rather big. But anyway, let's continue. So let's take a look here. All right. Okay, another little part here that wants to come out for you, Cancer, is in this situation, I definitely see the deception card. It's followed by the third party card. So in this reading, regardless of what role you are, I'm just sensing there was a third party situation that definitely led to this epic downfall. A lot of unscrupulous activities, I think a lot of purposeful hiding, all sorts of stuff. But I see again, Cancer, that you may have, it's almost like this energy that you did, it's something you did to kind of put a stop to your role in it. It's like, okay, I don't know what this is, but now I'm on this speeding train, but I'm gonna get off this train. So see how you stand up here and everybody else kind of does their own thing? It's like you said to yourself, I'm going to stop. And I feel like today the wishes fulfilled in the Nine of Cups situations that you have for yourself and the good things that you have for yourself, as we see here, you're in your Divine Feminine, your Empress mode, is because you have decided, you've made a decree to God that you don't want to be that kind of person who is involved in that kind of situation. But I'm seeing this deception, I'm seeing this as a male energy, male or female, right? So some of you may have been involved with somebody, a married man or something to that effect, or somebody who's in a more of a significant relationship than he let on. But there's this deception here. Because see this rope? And then it looks like the rope is continuing. So this person, I feel, may have done some lying. And but I think, and remember, this is you today as this Queen of Wands looking quite like you've transmuted a lot of energy, and notice that your back is turned to this person who's coming across as the Queen of, as the King of Wands. I wouldn't be surprised if communication is limited between the two of you right now, because I'm seeing this cat almost going between to talk to your guides who's talking to you, and then going between to talk to this, his guides who are talking to him. So it's almost like this energy, you may be even in two different places, but I'm just seeing that, yeah, and I think this person may be wanting to reach out to you in some way, whether it's to get back to you or to get settled or to feel better about things, or maybe there's guilt, there's shame, there's whatever it is that's going on. I feel this person has a lot of growing to do, and I think that for the most part, you have kind of put this person to rest in your mind. This is what I'm seeing here. So it's like this guy seems to be this guy, and it's like you are burying this situation, whether or not this person wants to reach out to you. But I do see that your back is turned to this person. So if you guys are watching Cancer, dear God, if you are the person who was cheated on and you're watching this video, I just want to let you know that this third-party person, if your husband or your wife cheated with somebody else or multiple other people, I'm getting a nurse. There's a nurse connection here. There's a nurse connection. But I'm getting that this third-party person isn't even thinking about this guy anymore, or your person. They're not thinking about your person anymore. They're working on themselves, right? That's what I'm seeing here. And let's see. I think what these cards are trying to say is that this was a hard situation all around, but I think that whoever the third person is, this reading is told from their perspective. I see them I see them receiving something of value from this situation that was very hard. But I also see them willingly and just naturally, because they know it's just what needs to be done. This person comes across as mature in many ways, shelling out, creating that balance in whatever way that they can. So again, I'm seeing this karmic situation, okay? Now, that being said, from this whole situation, this whole epic letdown, this major disaster, so to speak, I'm seeing that you, Cancer, or whoever it is that is, whosever story this is, which I do believe is the third party, I feel that you've learned something of value that you can go back home and put on your shelves, your inner shelves. It's like, I learned something. And notice that she's seeing her reflection. This is a lesson. This is a spiritual lesson. Hard one. Yeah. And again, I'm seeing just this. I'm seeing all this energy here. This is, again, coming back to a school energy. This, whatever this was very, I don't want to say licentious. It was very dark. It wasn't a good situation. But I'm seeing her face here, closing her eyes to all of this stuff. So this is definitely a lesson learned, and a well-rounded lesson learned as well. Usually when we look at spiritual lessons, we always want to see this kind of transmutation happening. You know, we always hope that we can work through whatever it is. Now, let's draw some cards, because this was a really quick reading, and I'm not surprised, because this kind of energy, when energy is transmuted so much, it's almost like the he said, she said, and the this and that just doesn't come up, because the energy is worked through to a large degree. But let's see, Spirit, what messages do you have for our Cancers for the month of December? Do you have any sneak peeks? Okay, any sneak peeks, guys? Okay, great. Okay, yeah, so looking at December, yeah, again, I'm just seeing when it comes to love, I feel like they're still looking at this. They're looking at this transmutation. Notice your video is all about the before and after. We've seen that again here. In the before, you may have found yourself left out in the cold, but choosing to move on from something that was just devastating. We see this Five of Pentacles energy here, right? This is you moving on, whoever this is in the reading. But, and then here you are looking back on yourself and what you were working towards in the past, which I feel like was this shadowy energy, like I said. And notice how you're in all color now, and it's almost like you're on your way out, heading to you know, maybe do something else, and you're seeing that old part of you. And you're kind of remembering how you used to be. But you've changed, and I'm seeing that here, and you're now making more gainful efforts. You're being a better force in this world. I see that because of what you've done, you've created, because of the good work that you've done, you've created a solid foundation for yourself. And I'm seeing that, yes, there may still be a little bit of drama, I'm hearing, but a little bit of grief. But I'm feeling that you've put that kind of behind you for the most part. And if there's someone trying to reach out to you who's still caught up in that stuff, you're choosing not to look back. And instead, you're focusing on working working on yourself, doing your stuff. And because of that kind of focus on moving on and letting go of things, you are in a solid foundation now. You're in a much better position. And the card that came up is this, the Empress, right? This is a fully transmuted situation. Yeah. Yeah, and I just feel like when it comes to love, there's this idea that I'm going to pour this out and I'm going to wait for the right thing to come along. I'm just going to wait for a better thing to come along because I don't want to be caught up in this half in, half out energy and this and that. And I just feel like, yes, eventually time will come. They're saying, yes, eventually time will come and time will tell, but there will be a time to make amends, they're saying. So there may still be some people that you need to make amends to and whatnot, and, you know, karmic balancing, but all of that will work out as it is to be worked out. But for now, it's all about you kind of getting settled where you are, focusing. Now, in this group here, I'm seeing you as being you, this person. I'm seeing you as being this person who's just kind of sitting there, kind of going with the flow, taking in the single moment, they're saying. So you're coming across as single, having made a new beginning, all right? Now, I think that if somebody is looking for you from the past, they may be trying to reach you, but I just don't see you really giving too much to that situation anymore. You're opting for a new beginning. You're smelling this flower that you randomly picked off this edge, but you're throwing away this bag that may still have things relating to the past. So it's just trying to move into something new, right? So my dear Cancer, that is what has come up for you. And looks, obviously this reading was a love reading because this one card came out. I forgot to bring it, but it's clearly a love reading for you. And talking about the direction that you have taken as a result of any fragmentation that happened because of this reading. I mean, not because of this reading, because of your past. All right. So obviously this message isn't going to be for everybody, but there are definitely people out there for whom this resonates. As you know, you could be any party in here, but this clearly was told from the position of the third person, whether Cancer, you are that person. If you're watching and this seems like your story, but you're not the third party, then this is showing you what's going on the third party's end. And that's just the message that came through today. All right, so thank you so much, and God bless you guys. More is coming through. Okay. Yeah, this was a tough reading for me personally because this clearly is my story, except I'm not the third party. So just as I literally put these cards down and I knew Spirit wanted to comment on something. All right. Okay, being an obedient servant. So Spirit is showing that whoever this King of Cups is, I'm seeing a King of Cups. I feel this person is the King of Wands. All right? I'm seeing this person having a lot of disappointments in love. So for some of you, if you're not the third party, this could be, and you're the one who was cheated on, this could be your husband or your wife or somebody, whoever did the adulterating. I'm seeing that this person, for some of them, because there are a few of you on the line, right? For some of them, I'm seeing this person has had a lot of disappointments in love in their lifetime. But, you know, people leaving them, I'm seeing now they're disappointed also if this third party left them. Or you know, it may not even be that they're thinking about this third party and that they wanted this third party for something serious. It may be just that they have things on the inside that they need to heal. But for whatever it is, I'm also seeing that for some of you, this may be your November reading and this may be what's coming up in December or something. But for most of you, I feel like this is what's going on in November. Congratulations to whoever's transmuted that energy. This seems like the past leading up to this. But I feel that this person has had a lot of disappointments in love. I'm feeling they also may not have taken love seriously. I'm seeing a lot of immaturity on their end. I'm seeing some of them may have tried to get rid of evidence. This is not all of them. Okay, remember, personal readings are where you need to go for details. So please don't get triggered into anything. But some of them may have tried to get rid of evidence. There may be Okay. Nieces, I'm hearing, what? Nieces may be involved in this? Okay, listen, I'm just giving messages. Nieces may be involved in this. I'm hearing nephews, nieces, nephews. Whether it's them that the affair happened with, or, you know, they know something that, and this person's trying to intercept them so they don't say anything. But either way, this person has a lot of healing to do. And again, I'm not seeing all of them having tried to get rid of evidence. Some of them may have just given it up when confronted, right? Personal readings is where you need to go. But I'm seeing that this person has had a lot of disappointments in love. I think that for some of them, they wouldn't know love if it slapped them in their face, because they have a lot to heal. So they may have somebody, see the Sun card, they may have somebody who really loves them, who's flying that banner from them, and they're doing everything they can to screw this relationship up, because they need to learn. They just have trauma. They've got past life things they need to work through. Whatever it is, they're so kind of messed up in the mind that I'm seeing these little, it's like this little girl, for example, is trying to hold this banner up to say, I love you, this is us, we can get this together. And this person is just so wounded that they can't see that, and they're trying to sabotage this. And look at these sunflowers. But when they're here on this person's head, they don't recognize it as sunflowers. They recognize it as some design or some notch in their hat. So maybe they may be mistaking a serious relationship with somebody for something not serious, because they can't understand. See, they can't realize that this is the match that they should be with. And so they're out with third parties because they don't have that. They just can't see that. So Spirit is trying to say, some people, for some of you on the call, I think that's why they're drawing these cards for you. Some of you on the call may have been the one cheated on. They're trying to say, this cheater may see, or adulterer is what they want us to say, this adulterer may see you as just a feather in the hat. You know, I don't wanna go on with you like that. Don't wanna be a feather in your hat. That's that kind of feather. They might see you as a feather in the hat because they are incapable of being connected in the heart space and actually seeing, oh my God, this is who God gave me. This is the sun. This is a divine connection. See how they're wearing pretty much the same headdress, but they can't see that because they've been traumatized at a young age. They were in devil energy that led them to whatever third party situation this is, right? Look at that. They made mistakes. They couldn't see this love situation. And it's like, what I'm seeing here is, this is the love situation that God ordained, right? And she gave him this apple, but he's giving it back and he's off going somewhere else to be over here because he's not able to see. And through that, he slipped right off the lover's card and into the devil card because he's not able to, he or she, whatever, not able to discern the difference. And that speaks to the level of health that that person, emotional health, inside health that they're working with, tower moment, okay? So this is that story here. So Spirit is choosing to come through with that story because we're clearly seeing this from the third party point of view, and they've worked through their stuff, right? But I'm seeing here that this guy connected to this reading has got, that's what brought that person into this realm of third party situation. So if you're resonating with this reading this month and you were the one that was cheated on, I really do feel that that connection with this person was God-given, seeing the destiny card right there. So maybe if you've been like, dude, what's going on? If you were blindsided by this tower card, that's because, you know, this, I feel like this was, I don't want to say a mistake, because from our vantage point, right, we don't really know. The higher up you go, the more nothing seems like a mistake, but there were definitely some mistakes here, made here, that if shadows were worked through, wouldn't have been worked through. Okay, I'm seeing this as the, the Queen of Swords. So some of you may be wondering whether to cut this person out. If this person cheated on you, you may be wondering whether to cut this person out. You may be in a place to cut them out. You may be in of the mindset to do that. I'm feeling that Spirit is saying that before you do make any cuts to this King of Wands, or, you know, this wounded King of Wands, they're saying to look closer at something. What is this? They're saying I think they're pointing at this card. Hold on. What are you trying to say? There's... hold on. I don't want to misspeak. Let me check first. Oh. All right. They're saying before you send this person packing, before you send this person packing for what they've done, they want you to try a different approach to this. They want you to get into your emperor or empress mode, see that crown, and they want you to think, use all the tools at your disposal, praying, you know, whatever it is, and think twice, because they're saying you're still too wounded right now to make that decision. When we're wounded, we're so wounded, sometimes we also have trouble seeing what God has placed for us. Isn't that what they're saying happened, exactly happened to this guy? He's so wounded, he could not tell that this is a God-given relationship. He gave them that apple right back, and slipped into the devil card, because the core wounds need to be healed. And so here you are, if you're in this position where you're like, dude, that man cheated on me with a third party, and you know she left him because, look, she's doing well, and what's he doing, right? Whatever it is, before you make that cut, they're saying they want you to get out of your own wounding. See, that's you in the right. You're like, I'm ready to cut. Before you do that, take a look at your own wounding. Allow for yourself to have judgment and the rebirth that comes with it. They're saying, let us take control of this situation. Let us mete out any judgments, any karmic scales, any rebalancings, any whatever, rebirth. Let us put things back in order. Let us create the transformation for this situation. And then, from then on, because this is you, right, having this feeling left out in the cold, before you move on, let us get everything together and then get into the Seven of Pentacles energy, where you're looking to see what you can cull, what lessons you can cull from this situation, and then from there, make your decision. Boom, two cards came out. Then from there, make your decision from that healed standpoint about what you should do. I'm not saying anything, but I'm like, because you heard what they said. Basically, they said, chill out, take a chill pill, let us work on this situation, let us work with this guy or girl, let us work with you, because third party person is on their way straight to whatever it is that they're doing now. But now we have to bring healing to this situation, they're saying. And so they're saying, before you make any cuts as the Queen of Swords, no matter how juicy that neck looks like and how sharp that knife looks like and how angry you are, they're saying, let's work on you. Get to a place where you things are balanced again and you can finally make a better in a more informed decision, because you're no longer in this place of severe wounding, which is kind of where he was or she was when they stepped out of this connection. See, the two cards that came up to represent you. Bing, there we go. Queen of Cups, not pointing it out as being a match for the King of Cups, but I'm just saying, God bless. Ten of Cups, solid foundation, solid happy home life. You know, they're saying that, yes, the house isn't ready to move in yet, because things need to be erected first. Things need to be put back in order. Whatever was broken down from this situation has to be put back in order. But it's important to get everybody on the same page, because I'm seeing this as you, like all of you. You, the King of Cups, and all of your spirit guides. Are we back here together again? Are we here? Or do we still want this contract? Are we, you know? And so, if you came here and this sounds like your story and you're wondering whether to let go of this person who engaged in a third-party situation when they were supposed to be with you, first of all, this is validation that, yes, they were definitely supposed to be with you. And, yes, there was a mistake made here, all right? I'm just here to validate that for you. And, yes, Spirit is saying you need to wait. It would be best for you to wait. Don't make any cuts. You can take a break from this person temporarily, but as far as like saying, I don't want to be with this person for the rest of this lifetime, they're saying, let us work our magic. Now, two cards totally just flew across the room right now. It is behind this camera and I went to get it. Notice this card is in the up right side up, and when it's in the right side up, this side is upside down. Same here. So the way I interpret this is, it's just summarizing what they're saying. If you make a new beginning, when you let go of this person cheated on you, you're not going to have this Ace of Cups that God gave you, that God originally gave the two of you, okay? And they're saying, if you don't make a new beginning and you choose to kind of like be on standby, focus on you instead, then they can work their magic and you can definitely have this new beginning with this person. But either way, there has to be healing taking place for both of you. This person's already doing their stuff, all right? They've done it. Expertly, by the way. Expertly. Surgically, expertly. So, yes. Anything else, Spirit? I'm afraid to, like, say, we're done, and then something else comes through. Let's see. I know, guys. It's hard. It's really hard. I know. I feel that for some of you, you still have to mourn the loss, the losses, the expectations that you had in connection, with this, I almost said with this religion, that might mean something to somebody. That you need to mourn whatever losses. Maybe you thought, wow, this person just came in, took what was mine, and we could have had something together. I wanted to have kids with this person. You got to let go of all of that and let God kind of step in. Because they're saying that if you don't, you're going to, you might miss an opportunity here. All right, anything else, Spirit? Yeah, all right, guys, so I think that is the end. I'm sorry if it was all over the place, but it's the energy that's coming through, and I did my best. This was a hard reading for me personally. You know, this and the Libra reading from last month, October, so I'm here, all right? So I really hope that you can glean something. Remember that if you'd like a personal reading, please do reach out to me, and I'd be more than happy to do that. If you would like to donate, then that would be amazing as well. Thank you so much. I always appreciate the generosity. And of course, I absolutely love you, and we're just going to say a quick prayer for everybody on this call. All right. Thank you so much, dear God, for bringing us all into equilibrium, because we all need that. We do understand that things happen on earth, and sometimes we don't have the foresight, we don't have the hindsight, we don't have the during sight. And we just hope that whatever information you give us, it comes from the highest good and can be used for our highest good, and all else be released into the light for healing and transmutation. We pray for healing for all parties involved. This seems like a really rough one, and we know that there is something to be gleaned for everybody in this situation. We ask, please, for you to help us to lead by example in forgiveness and just healing. Please help us to be focused on what we need to be focused on. Please don't let us suffer any more than we need to. And please let us just move forward with as much integrity as possible, moving on from this situation. And if we can all make an agreement not to, you know, speak out of turn or hurt other people, especially in the name of our feelings, that would be amazing. But we also do ask that we have people there to nurture us and to help us through whatever it is that we are going through, so that our own recovery and our own self-forgiveness can be smooth. And we just pray that in God's name. All right. Thank you. Amen. Thanks, angels. Thanks, guys. All right. Thank you so much, the rest of you guys. And please have a blessed November. Don't forget to tune in for the daily readings. You know, with my daily readings, most days I open it up to personal messages. So you can always ask your angels to come through with some personal messages for you during those readings. Okay? Have a very, very, very blessed day. Bye. Mwah. Bye.